Good morning, dear students. Today I am going to continue the same part. The next topic is internal resistance. When a cell is closed, means when the current passes through it, then it flows from, then the electron flows from negative terminals to the positive terminal, while outside the cell through the external circuit due to the flow of free electron. It flows from anode to cathode in the external circuit and from cathode to anode inside the cell. Cathode to anode inside the cell means from excess to deficiency, and outside the cell it flows from the anode to cathode means from the positive terminal to the negative terminal. As I explained that the current always flows from the higher potential to lower potential, and the electron flows from the excess to defect. As we all know, when the current flows, then it requires two electrodes and the electrolytes. For the cell, it requires two electrodes and electrolyte. One behaves like cathode and the other behaves like anode. So inside the electrolyte, when the current flows, then because of the free electron and the fixed positive ion, there is some loss of energy. Because of that, the potential difference or the potential is low. The current flows with the low potential difference. The resistance which is offered to the flow of current by these fixed positive ion and the free electron inside the electrolyte is called internal resistance. So internal resistance is the resistance offered by the electrolyte inside the cell to the flow of current when the circuit is closed. Next we have the relation between EMF, potential difference, and the internal resistance. EMF is represented by the letter epsilon. Internal resistance is small r, and the potential difference or the terminal voltage is V. As we all know that V is equals to IR or I is equals to V by R. Here we have, in place of V, we have the EMF, and in place of resistance, when the current flows through the conductor, then the total resistance is internal resistance and the external resistance. Internal resistance is resistance offered to the flow of current by the electrolyte. So we have the total resistance small r plus capital R. So current I is equals to epsilon by small r plus capital R. So the relation is epsilon is equals to I capital R plus small r. Now the factors affecting the internal resistance. There are four factors which affect the internal resistance. The first is surface area, second is the distance between the electrolyte, third is the nature of electrolyte, and fourth is the temperature. How the internal resistance is affected by these factors. The first is surface area. Larger area offers less resistance, because if the area is more, then it gets more place to move the electrons. So the larger area offers less resistance. Distance between the electrode. If the distance is more, then the more resistance will be offered, because there will be more distance to move to the electrons. Because of that, there is more loss of energy, so more resistance will be offered. Nature of electrolyte, less ionic, or if the concentration is more, then they offer more internal resistance. Temperature, as we increase the temperature means we give the energy to the electrolyte, then the ion starts vibrating or moving with more energy, so they offer less resistance to the flow of current. Now the combination of resistor. There are two types of combination. First is series and the second one is parallel. In case of series combination, the resistance are connected with each other, one after the other. They are connected with the same wire, one after the other. So in this condition, we have the same current, but the different potential. Different potential difference, but we have the same current. So the net potential difference is V is equals to V1 plus V2 plus V3. V is equals to IR, current is constant, so it is IR1 plus IR2 plus IR3. I is taken as a common, so in a bracket we have R1 plus R2 plus R3. I is in multiplication, it will be in division. By the Ohm's law, we know that V by I is equals to R. So R is equals to R1 plus R2 plus R3. Here the resistance are joined with each other by the single wire, so the same current will flow to each resistor, so the current will be constant. The second is parallel. In parallel combination, all the resistance are joined from the same fixed point, but they are joined individually. So because of that, they have the same potential difference, but they have the different current. So the net current is I1 plus I2 plus I3. Then we apply formula I is equals to V by R, V by R1, because the potential difference is same. V is taken as a common and it is in division. I by V. I by V is 1 by R. So we have 1 by R is equals to 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2 plus 1 by R3. It means that when the resistors are joined parallel, then we get the combination of the resistors by the formula 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2 plus 1 by R3. In this condition, all the resistors are joined by the same fixed point individually. So watch the video carefully to try to solve the numerical based on the combination of series, that is parallel and series.